Hello viewers, I am Deepti Hans. Today we are here to discuss ICSE Specimen Question Paper Mathematics 2023. We are going to start with section A, which consists of only three questions. Question 1 is of MCQ, 15 marks. Question 2, 4 marker each, 12 marks. And question 3, 13 marks. Total 40 marks for section A. We are going to start with part 1, which is the SGST paid by a customer to the shopkeeper for an article which is priced at rupees 500 is rupees 15. The rate of GST charges. SGST is given. SGST, it means let X percent of rupees 500 is 15. Then X percent means 100, of means multiply 500. It means 5X is equal to 15. X is equal to 15 upon 5, it means 3%. But they have asked us GST. GST is SGST plus CGST. It means 3 plus 3, 6%. So our correct option is part D, which is 6%. In second part, when the roots of a quadratic equation are real and equal, then the discriminant of the quadratic equation is, we all know D is equal to 0. For equal roots and for real roots, D is 0. So our correct option is C. Our third part is, if x minus 1 is a factor of 2x squared minus ax minus 1. Suppose it is gx. X minus 1 is a factor, so we have to take here 1. Putting value of 1 instead of x, we are getting this. And this is a factor, it means remainder is 0. So 2 minus a minus 1 is 0. 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 minus a is 0. So a is equal to 1. A is equal to 1 is our part B. So in third part, correct option is B. In fourth part, which is given that AC BD is a matrix, multiply it with X, another matrix, and product is PQ. The order of matrix, this one is. Now, order of first matrix is 2 by 2. Order of third matrix is 2 by 1. We know that number of column here is equal to number of rows in this. So, it is 2 and then 1. So, the order of this X matrix is 2 by 1. This is our option C. In next part, 57, 54, 51 and 48 are in AP. 57, 54, 51 and 48, they are in AP. So A is 57 first term, B is 54 minus 57, it means minus 3. Value of 8th term is, we need to calculate A8. We know the formula A plus N minus 1D. 8 minus 1D. Value of A is 57 plus 7 and D is minus 3. 57 minus 21. It means 36. 36 is our correct option A. So in fifth part, our correct option is A. In part number 6, the point A, P, Q is invariant about X is equal to P under reflection. X is equal to P under reflection. Suppose this X is equal to P under reflection. It remains invariant. First of all, try to understand what is an invariant. Any point that remains unaltered under a given reflection. So here our answer of its image A dash is P Q again. So correct option is part number C. In part number 7, diagram is given. Triangle ABC. Right angled at B, this is A, B and C, and similar to triangle DEF. This is 18, this is 24 centimeter, this is 4 centimeter and this is 3 centimeter. It is given that these two triangles are similar. We just have to tell the similarity, which similarity is in between them. So here we can see AB upon DE is equal to BC upon EF. What is the value of AB? 4, BE is 24, BC is 3 and EF is 18. 4, 6, 3, 6. The value comes out to be 1 by 6. It means they are equal. So, which type of similarity? Angle angle B is equal to angle E is equal to 90 degree. So, this is SAS similarity. Two sides and including angle. SAS similarity is our part number B. So, correct option is B for question number, part number 7. In 8, volume of a right circular cone with same base radius. We all know that cone has a volume 1/3 of a cylinder. This is a cylinder. Its volume is pi r square h. And what is the volume of a cone? Pi r square h. We can draw a cone in between these because it is given that same base radius, it means r is same for both cone and cylinder, and height is also same for both. And volume of circular cone is given, it is 120. It is 120 centimeter cube. So value of pi r square h is 3 into 120, it means 360 centimeter cube. This is our option number C. So correct option is C. In next part, the solution set for the given inequation. Inequation is given minus 8 is less than and equal to 2x is less than 8 and x belongs to whole number. Now, we need to split in two parts. Minus 8 is less than 2x. So, x is less than equal to minus 8 upon 2 or you can say minus 4. In this part, 2x is less than 8, x is less than 8 upon 2, x is less than 4. So, you can collectively write them, x is greater and less than minus 4 and less than 4. So, x belongs to whole number and we know whole numbers start from 0. So, our solution set contain numbers 0, 1, 2 and 3. Because there is no equality sign here, so we could not include 4 here. So, our correct option is C of 9th part also. In 10th part, the probability of the sun rising from the east is PS. The value of PS is, we all know that sun always rises in the east. So, probability is 100%. So, PS is equal to 1. This is our option number C. In part number 11, these three matrices are given. Sum of first and second matrix is equal to third matrix multiplied by 3. Second matrix is multiplied by 3. So, we have to find the value of x here. Now, 2x, 0, 1. First matrix remain as it is. 3 is multiplied with all the members. 3 to the 6, 3, 12 and 0. And on the right hand side, equation is 8, 8, 12 and 1. Because we need to find the value of x, we just need to take the value of a 1, 2 element. So, its value comes out to be x plus 3 equal to 8. X is equal to 8 minus 3, it means 5. So, our correct option is B in this case. Now, in next part, 12th part, centroid of triangle ABC is G6, 7. Centroid is the center point inside a triangle where all the three medians meet. We know all the three medians meet at this point. So this is the centroid. Value of centroid is given as 6 and 7. If the coordinates of the vertices A, B, C are, A coordinates are A and 5, B are 7 and 9, and coordinates of C are 5 and 7. So, we need to find the value of A. So, we just need to calculate x coordinates of all these three points. Now, we know the formula for centroid is A1 plus A2 plus A3 divided by 3. So, A1 is A, A2 is 7, A3 is 5 divided by 3. And its value is given as 6. So, A plus 12 is 18. A is 18 minus 12, it means 6. Value of A comes out to be 6 and it is our correct option number B. In next part, in the given diagram, AC is the diameter. This is a question from chapter Circles. Here in the given diagram, these are the points A and B. This is C. This angle is given as 35 degree. This is X, and AC is given as the diameter of the circle. This AC is diameter. We all know that diameter makes an angle of 90 degree. So it means this angle is of 90 degree. Angle ABC is of 90 degree. We just need to write angle in a semicircle. Angle ADB is 35, ADB is 35, and this angle ACB, angle ACB is again 35, angle made by same arc AB, made by same arc. So in triangle ABC, by angle sum property, one angle 180 minus one angle is of 90 degree, one angle is of 35 degree. 180 minus 125. It means value comes out to be 55 degree, and correct option is A. 13th part, A option is correct. In part number 14, if the nth term of arithmetic progression AP is n plus 3, nth term AN is n plus 3, then the first three terms of AP are, first term is A1, it means 1 plus 3 means 4. A2 is 2 plus 3 means 5. A3 is 3 plus 3 means 6. So 4, 5 and 6 are the first three terms of this AP, and this is our correct option number C. In last 15 part of question number 1, the median of a group frequency distribution is found graphically by drawing. We know cumulative frequency curve. OGIF is drawn for this purpose. So our correct option is D. Question number 2 consists of 3 parts. All are of 4 marks. So total 12 marks. In part number 1, Salman deposits rupees 1200 every month. So principal amount is P is equal to rupees 1200. Time is given as 2.5 years. It means 2 years means 24 months and half means 6. It means 30 months. So N is equal to 30 months. Now rate is given as 6% per annum. Find the amount he will receive on maturity. It means maturity value. P into N plus P into N, N plus 1 into rate upon 100 into 2 into 12. Now P into N, value of P is 1200 into N is 30 plus again 1200 into 30 into 31. Rate is 6 divided by 2 into 12 into 100. Zeros are cut. 36,000 plus this value comes out to be 2790. So addition 38790. Rupees 38790. Is maturity value which Salman will get after 2.5 years. In second part, 3, 9, M, 81 and N are in continued proportion. Find the values of M and N. We know when three numbers are in continued proportion, we need to write them as 3 upon 9 and 9 upon M. So cross multiplying, M, 3M is equal to 9, 9, M is equal to 81 upon 3, it means value of M comes out to be 27. In this part, in these three numbers, M upon 81 is equal to 81 upon N. Value of M is 27 upon 81, 81 upon N. 27 N is equal to 81 into 81. So N is equal to 81 into 81 upon 27. And 27, 3, 81. So N is equal to 81 into 3, it means 243. So value of M is 27 and value of N is 243. In part number 3, दिस इज फ्रॉम ट्रिग्नोमेट्री. कॉस ए अपॉन 1 प्लस साइन ए अपॉन कॉस ए इक्वल टू 2 sec ए. दिस इज अवर राइट हैंड साइड. वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ दिस. टेकिंग एलसीएम ऑन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड 1 प्लस साइन ए एंड कॉस ए इन मल्टीप्लीकेशन. इन द डिनोमिनेटर कॉस स्क्वेयर ए प्लस 1 प्लस साइन ए स्क्वेयर इक्वल टू कॉस स्क्वेयर ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वेयर. ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर प्लस 2ab अपॉन 1 प्लस साइन ए एंड कॉस ए. नाउ वी नो द आइडेंटिटी साइन स्क्वेयर प्लस कॉस स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू 1 एंड दिस 1 प्लस 1 प्लस 2 साइन ए डिवाइडेड बाय कॉस ए 1 प्लस साइन ए. इट मीन्स 2 प्लस 2 साइन ए कॉस ए 1 प्लस साइन ए. टेकिंग 2 कॉमन 1 प्लस साइन ए इन द डिनोमिनेटर कॉस ए 1 प्लस साइन ए. नाउ वी कैन फाइनली कट देम. नाउ 2 अपॉन कॉस ए एंड 1 अपॉन कॉस ए इज नोन एज sec ए. सो 2 sec ए इज अवर राइट हैंड साइड. सो हेंस प्रूफ लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सेक्शन ए ऑफ 13 मार्क्स 4, 4 एंड 5. इन पार्ट नंबर 1 द इनर सर्कमफ्रेंस of the rim of a circular metal tub is 44 centimeter. So we know the circumference formula for this is 2 pi r inner 44. So here radius comes out to be 44 upon 2 and value of pi is 22 upon 7. So radius is 7 centimeter. Inner radius comes out to be 7 centimeter. Now this is our A part. Calculate the inner radius of the tub. In B part, volume of the material of the tub, if its outer radius is 8 centimeter. So, volume of material outer radius is 8. So, formula is 2 by 3 pi r cube minus small r cube, outer minus inner. So, 2 by 3 value of pi is 22.7, capital R is 8, so 8 cube. Inner radius is 7, so 7 cube, 44 upon 21, and 8 cube is 512, and 7 cube is 343, 44 upon 21 into, after minus, this is 169. So after calculating this, comes out to be 7436 upon 21, it means 354.09 centimeter cube. But they have asked, give your answer correct to three significant figures. Three significant figure means total three digits should be there. So our answer is 354 centimeter cube. In second part of question number 3, this figure is given in which we have to write the coordinates of A and B. In A part, we just need to write the coordinates of A and B. So, coordinates of A R, which is on x-axis, so 5 and 0, and coordinates of B R, which lies on y-axis, so 0 and 3. Now in B part, if P divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 3, find the coordinates of point P. Suppose they are x and y. So we need to find, we just draw a straight line for making our calculation simpler. This is B 0, 3. This is A 5, 0. This is P XY and ratio is 2 is to 3. Now we know the formula M1 X2 plus M2 X1 divided by M1 plus M2. So in this case, just multiply this number ratio with the coordinates on right hand side and left on right on left hand side. So 3 multiplied 15 means 15 plus 0 divided by 3 plus 2, it means 5. These are coordinates of x. And then y, 0 plus m1 y2 plus m2 y1, m1 plus m2, 0 plus 6, 3 to 6 upon 5. So here 15 upon 5, it means 3, and 6 upon 5, y value comes out to be 6 upon 5. So coordinates of P are 3 and 6 upon 5. This is our part number B. In third part, they have asked to find the equation of a line which is parallel to line AB and passing through origin. Now, we know that any line parallel to AB, any line parallel to AB has same slope. So we just need to calculate the slope of AB, because we know slope of AB is equal to the any parallel line slope. So formula for slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So 3 minus 0 upon 0 minus 5. It means 3 upon minus 5 is the slope, m. Now, line having slope this and origin point is 0, 0. So point is 0, 0. Now we need to use point slope form, which is y minus y1 is equal to m x minus x1. So y minus x1 point, y1 point is 0, m slope is 3 upon minus 5, x is x and x1 is again 0. So value comes out to be 5y is equal to minus 3x. This is the equation of the line 5y minus 3x. Having slope equal to the slope of AB and coordinates 0, 0. Point is 0, 0. So we can also write 3x plus 5y equal to 0. In last part of question number 3, use graph sheet for this question and take 2 cm is equal to 1 unit. So we need to write 2 cm is equal to 1 unit. And in graph also, remember this thing. Along the axis, plot the point triangle OAB, where O is this point O, it means 0, 0. Next, A is 3 minus 2 on x-axis 3 and minus 2 on y-axis, it means 3 minus 2. 3 and minus 2, this is our A point. And B is 2 minus 3, 2 and minus 3, this is our B point, 2 and minus 3. We need to draw the triangle, so join O to A and then A to B. OAB is our triangle. Now reflect triangle OAB through the origin and name it as OA dash B dash. If we reflect this triangle through origin, then this will come to second quadrant. So our reflected number A dash comes out to be minus 3 and plus 2. Minus 3 on x-axis and plus 2 on y-axis. Minus 3 and 2, this is our A dash, reflected point through origin. And B dash, 2 minus 3 comes minus 2 and plus 3. Minus 2 and plus 3. This is our B dash, minus 2 and plus 3. Now, joining this triangle also, they just tell us to draw. Reflect the triangle OAB to the origin and name it as OA dash B dash. Okay. This is another triangle OA dash B dash. Now, third is reflect this triangle OA dash B dash on the y axis and name it as OA double dash B double dash. Now, B double dash comes here. Reflected through y axis, so y point will not change, x point will change, so 2 and 3. This is our B double dash. And minus 3, 2 is 3, 2. This is our A double dash. This is again reflected triangle. And now reflect this O A dash B dash on the x-axis and name it as O A triple dash and B triple dash. Now, when reflection through x-axis, then x point will not change. So, A triple dash is minus 3 and minus 2. This is our this point. And B point is minus 2, 3. Here it becomes minus 2 and minus 3. This is B triple dash. Now, in the last D part, they have told us to join these points a double dash. If we are joining these points, a double dash, then b double dash, then b dash. We need to join this line also, then b dash to a dash, then a dash to a triple dash, then b triple dash, and coming back to b. So this is our complete figure. Give the geometrical name of the closed figure so formed. So just count their corners. This is our first corner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So this is octagon. Octagon means having 8 sides. With this, we come to the end of section A. On request of many of my viewers, I have made this video. Hope you would like it, because success of my channel depends only on my viewers. Thank you.